certainly much the same way as over the following centuries. People enjoyed other deformed beings in the margins of illuminated pages, the so-called marginalia, and on the capitals of Romanesque churches. Medieval men found those monsters attractive just as we enjoy looking at exotic animals in a zoo. Proof of this is emphatic way in which a rigorous like St. Bernard, the Apologia ad Gaudium, condemns the sculptures on capitals that the faithful evidently found too attractive by half. But he describes them so well that we are led to suspect he himself had looked at them more closely than he should have done. What place is there in the cloisters for that ridiculous monstrosity, that strange kind of deformed shape or shaped deformity? What are foul apes doing there? What are foul apes doing there? What are foul apes?
What are foul apes doing there?